we can achieve, we can overcome the disadvantages, we can overcome the drawbacks what we have got in the policy model through Agile software. So in Agile model, whatever the requirements getting from the customers, we are dividing into a, that are decomposing into a small parts. That are decomposing into a small parts. That are decomposed into a small parts. And these small parts are developed incrementally. Are tend to be developed incrementally. Are incrementally developed. Then Agile model is able to adapt iterative development. Iterative development. Agile model adapt iterative development. So each incremental project is developed over an iteration. Okay, whatever the parts we have divided using that are developed incrementally. So how it is developed incrementally? Over iterations. Over iterations. Iterations means, for example, same part will be repeated for the each part of the requirements. What, for suppose we have a big requirement, that requirements we have divided into small parts. So that small parts incrementally developed over an iterations. So iterations means, suppose each iteration having planning, development and deployment. So this process will be repetitively, iteratively executed on each part, on each part of the requirement by incrementing each part. For example, we go for the next part of the requirement, we are using incremental development by performing iteration development. Next, each iteration can be completed within a couple of weeks. Can be completed within a couple of weeks. It will take some couple of weeks. Next, each iteration at a time, only one iteration is planned. At a time, only one iteration is planned. One iteration is planned, developed, and deployed to the customer. Okay. So this is how Agile software models work. Now what are the steps in Agile software development? Let us see. In Agile software development, what are the steps? The first step is requirement gathering. We have to gather the data, we have to collect the information related to your project. Next, requirement analysis. We have to do the analysis. We have to analyze what data we have got, what information we have got. Then we have, based on this two information, we have to start designing part. The team and the team leaders will start designing part of this information, whatever the data you may have got. Then fourth step is coding. So after collecting information, analyzing and designing, the next step obviously will come for the coding part. Next is unit testing. Unit testing. In unit testing, what it is, we test whatever the modules we have used in a coding part, developers will have designed modules. Each more part of the project modules will be tested individually. So finally, if it is test flawless, then it will be accepted. So that will be done in acceptance testing step. It is acceptance testing step. So these are the steps which we require in Agile software development. On what principles this Agile software development, it works on, let us see. The first principle of Agile software development, it gives highest priority to satisfy the customer. Giving highest priority to the customer, to satisfy the customer requirements, to satisfy the customer. Second is, it is able to adapt any changing requirements in the late development. In the late development means during project development. For example, a team leader have already got the information. what is the meaning of this word? Able to move quickly and easily. So whatever the projects we are developing using Agile model, we are able to finish the project quickly, and we are able to satisfy the customer, we are able to deliver the customer in time. So therefore we are telling frequently deliver project in time. And throughout the project, it is necessary all the business people and what are the team leaders and developers, they work on daily basis throughout the project until the project is done. And next is, so all the developers and the team members working on daily basis. And next thing is, face-to-face interaction is needed. Face-to-face interaction between whom? Face-to-face interaction between the business people, customers, is must and should be needed. So that definitely, because the name itself is indicating Agile. If you want to finish the project in a short time, then we need to know the customer requirements regularly. Definitely, interaction must be needed between the business people, between the developers and the customers. So face-to-face interaction is needed. Next is Agile model. Whatever the project we are developing through Agile model, they are very sustainable. Sustainable means whatever the project we are developing, it goes for a long time. We are able to maintain for long time. And here in Agile software development, whatever that we are developing through iterative model, through incremental model, and first we are dividing the requirements into several parts. That small parts are developing by incremental, and that increment each because Agile model is able to adapt iterations, so each incremental model will be developed over an iterations. So here, whatever the project we are getting, we are developing through an iterations. Here the developers are giving more emphasis on implementations, because as I said, what I said, in order to get the agility in our project, we need to remove the unwanted things, non-essential things. So therefore here the